Murrelektronik power supply concepts, the core of your control cabinet. Main core products are switch mode power supplies, transformers, MECO, which is 24 volt distribution, and IP67 power supplies. MECO is one of our best selling product ranges. It focuses on short circuit and overload protection for 24 volt distribution within the panel. Another huge focus in the design of these products, it's all about saving space within the panel and ensuring proper protection for your 24 volt system. The new product that we have on range at the moment is MECO Pro. It's a modular distribution system so that you can build up as you need which channels you need. There's a new product coming on the market very soon in the case of MECO Pro power supply, which is an integrated power supply into this system. It takes all the functions of the old input terminals and adds the benefit of having a 24 volt switch mode power supply with it still with variable voltage on the front there. We have the ability with this system to control each channel independently through the terminal on the top and wiring those individual points or wiring to the control circuit on the front there. This can also be done on the input terminal module. So with the global system, you are able to disable and enable the entire system as a whole. What it doesn't do for safety purposes is or modify anything that's been hard turned off. So as we turn off modules, those two turned off there see red. And then remotely turn the system on and off. It doesn't change the state of that module there. As we turn it back on, the module stays disabled. That's for safety purposes in case someone's doing maintenance on other parts of the system, or they've consciously turned that off because there isn't anything hit to the other end. It has multiple states, so as you can see here, green is healthy. As we apply more power to one of the loads, we can see here that it goes to a flashing state because it's at 90% of its set current limit. We have short circuit in the case of a red flashing light, which we can remotely reset. Or manually reset by hand. It has the orange status for remotely disabled, and we also have a modifiable current limit so that as we press this button we can increase the current up now to 10 amps or back down to 1 and then configure it. So with MECO Pro, there are added benefits for space saving in the face of the distribution block. It's currently available in 2x12 or 4x6 channels. So all we do is we take an output from one of the channels itself and feed it into the terminal block, and that gives us a 24 volt distribution as opposed to having a bank of terminals beneath or somewhere else within the panel. In the MECO basic range, we have the old style hard housing, which comes with fixed channel, 2 amps and 6 amp supplies, 8 channels on that one, or on the slimline version, only 4 channels. Again, fixed current outputs on load. There is a bridging system which can be used to go across the old style, or the classic style, shall I say. There is also then the MECO Plus, which has all the features and benefits of this one with the 90% warning, the remote control on and off, the remote reset and the alarm contact, and those come with rotary switches seen on here, configurable between 1, 2, 3 or 4 amps, 2, 4, 6 or 8, or 4, 6, 8 and 10. With the 24 volt switch mode power supplies, we have our premium range product, which is Impara. As you can see here, it covers a vast range of modules. Start off with the UPS. So with our UPS system, it's quite independent in that it actively monitors the battery, not just for temperature, but also for charge and capacity. It does this by monitoring the voltage and the resistance of the battery as it charges and discharges, to give a realistic capacity still within the battery itself. We can supply batteries, or we can supply you with a temperature sensor to integrate into anybody else's battery that you can buy from anywhere else across the world. This is more focused around keeping the system alive as long as possible. So when you are configuring through the micro USB port in the software, you can set the conditions at which the battery OK alarm will become live. It also gives you an active interface to see the status of the battery and the capacity of the battery. The batteries use a automotive fuse, because if the worst comes to the worst, you've always got an automotive fuse in your car you can go and pinch, rather than having to dig around for a glass fuse that may have become broken. We also have the Amparo buffer. Now, this module is more for keeping the control system alive long enough to store data down to retentive memory, as opposed to just holding the system alive. All you're doing is making sure that when the system comes back with power, you have all the information saved, stored, and ready to go. This is the full, the extremes of the range with the three phase, so that we have 5 amp three phase up to 40 amp three phase. Amparo system of power supplies boast some of the best MTBF figures on the market. It's currently, as far as we're aware, the most reliable power supply in the world. The 40 amp three phase comes with an added benefit called a pre-diagnostic alarm. Now, this isn't just an alarm to tell you when it's failed. This uses a calculation and an algorithm to determine when it's about to fail, so that you can change the power supply out before anything goes wrong, rather than being purely reactive. And you can actually change this into your PPMs and get it swapped out beforehand. Amparo power supplies in general offer three power boost features: 400% for 200 milliseconds. We have 150% for 4 seconds, and if the temperature is below 45 degrees C, it will run consistently at 120% for the lifetime of the product. It will affect the MTBF figures, but not in that large amount. We also have single phase units. We have, again, the extremes here from 5 amp to 20 amp. We have a 10 amp in between. These are keeping the same aesthetics of the range, in that they are compact, good for space, good for heat ventilation, so that you don't have to have too much space above and below compared to other power supplies. There's also a feature with the Amparo system that they are the most efficient power supplies on the market as a whole range, so that the minimum efficiency seen within an Amparo switch mode is 92% up to pushing 97% on the high end, which is with our 5, 10, 20 amp three phase units. Some of them boast an MTBF of over 120 years. We also do a filter for the panel, something that in my history as an engineer I haven't fitted that many of, and now see the error of my own ways. There are regulations that say we should minimise noise back to the system and the supply, and just by fitting a simple universal filter in this way, an input filter, it actually ticks that box as far as the regulations go. You can say that you've done everything you can to minimise the noise fed back into the supply. We also have Murrelektronik transformers. Now, these are not the cheapest of the cheap. They are completely flexible and bespoke to your needs. If you give us the specifications required, we can build a transformer for you. It's as simple as that. We also have a very, very high accuracy on VA, so that rather than building in a standard 10% contingency, if you actually try and specify close to 100% as possible, you will make that unit more efficient. Obviously, with a transformer, the magnetization fights each other when it's not at optimal range. We also then have IP67 power supplies. Now, we have the standard power supply, which is just in itself, comes in a 4 amp or an 8 amp unit, single phase, 3 pin 7/8 connection in, 5 pin 7/8 connection out, for 2 channel 24 volt, including earth. With the hybrid, it has the added benefit of having inbuilt a 2 channel MECO as part of that. Now, it does have IO-Link interface, so that you can monitor the current, the voltage, the internal temperature. Again, having a pre-diagnostic output with this unit, However, this IO link interface can be disabled, and that can be turned into a hardwired interface so that you have two pins feeding out when it's failed and two pins feeding in to reset remotely. When it's in the non-IO link function mode, you have the buttons on the front to be able to change the current ratings as required per each channel. So the unit as a whole can do 10 amps. Each channel is configurable 1 to 8 amps.